This tutorial will show you how to add and use Dyno Bot in your Discord server. Start by heading to the Dyno Bot website. Click Add to Server. Select your server using the drop menu. Continue. Adjust these settings if you like. Disabling some options may prevent some features from working properly. I typically leave all the permissions enabled. Authorize. Verify that you're a human. Select your server again. You will now be redirected to the Dyno dashboard. Now, you will need to select the prefix for your server. This is the symbol that will need to be placed before every command. We recommend keeping the question mark prefix to prevent any conflicts with other bots in your server. If you're watching this video in the future, then Dyno may have moved to using slash commands. Click Next. Click Next again, then press Done. Open Discord. Open the server settings. Switch to the Roles tab from the side. Drag the Dyno role so it's either just above or just below the moderator role. I'll be putting mine above. Save changes, then close. Right-click on the side panel and create a category. Name it Server Logs. Make the category private. Click Next. Add any admin or moderator roles as well as the Dyno Bot role. Create category. Right-click on the category and choose to edit. Switch to permissions. Expand the advanced permissions. Select the moderator role. Scroll down and enable the ability to send messages. Save changes. Select the Dyno Bot role. Enable the send messages permission. Save changes, then close. Click the plus icon next to the new category. Make a text channel. Name the channel Mod Logs. Create channel. Repeat this process to make channels for Automod logs and general logs. Switch back to Dyno Bot. Select modules from the side. Here you have all of the primary features of Dyno Bot. Each feature has a brief description of what it does and can be enabled and disabled using the switch. Feel free to enable whatever feature you want. For the purpose of this tutorial, we will be showing you how to set up the more commonly used modules, that being Automod, Moderation, Action Log, Twitch, Reaction Roles, and Auto Roles. Click the Automod Settings button. Open the Log Channel menu on the right. Select the Automod Logs channel. Expand the Banned Words drop menu and you will see the punishment options. Delete will delete the message. Warn will warn the user about the rule they broke. The warning message will automatically be deleted after a few seconds. Automute will create and apply a muted role to the offender, preventing them from sending messages in your server. Automute allows you to set how many times a user must break the rule to be muted. If you want to use your own role for Automute, then you will need to ensure that it is named Muted. Once someone has been muted by Dyno Bot, you can then change the name of the role. We have a text and video tutorial for creating a muted role linked in the description. Instant Mute will instantly mute the user after one offense. Auto Ban will automatically ban a user from your server for a selected period of time after a selected amount of infringements. Instant Ban will ban a user instantly. Each rule can have multiple punishments set to prevent repeat offenders. Go through and set all of the punishments you want for each offense. Feel free to pause the video and copy our settings. Scroll down and you will see the general punishment settings. These will affect all options set above. The first box is how long a user will be muted or banned for if they break the rules. Set this between 10 and 60 minutes. The mute or ban violations are how many times a user must break the rules to receive an auto mute or auto ban. Set this somewhere between 3 and 10. The link cooldown is how many seconds must pass before a user can send another link. We recommend setting this to 30 seconds. Max emoji count is how many emojis a message can have. Set this between 4 and 10. Finally, the mass mention count is how many roles or members a user can mention in a message. Set this around 3 or 5. Be sure to click the Update button next to each setting to save your changes. Scroll down and you will see the Ignore Channels and Allowed Roles section. These are the channels and roles that aren't affected by the Automod. Add any channels you like. Typically, you will want to leave this empty or add mod channels. Add any admin, moderator, or bot roles. Scroll back up. If you want to change the Automod settings for a single option, then click the gear icon. We like to adjust the settings for banned words and Discord invites. Here you can add ignored channels, ignored rules, and custom auto mute settings. For banned words, I tend to set the mute violations to 3. Save when you're happy. Click the gear icon under the Discord invites heading. Set the mute violations to 2 or 3, and time between 30 and 60 minutes. Save. Refresh the page and ensure that all of your settings have been saved. If some settings aren't saved, then you will need to reset them. Click the gear icon and click Save. Switch to the Banned Words tab at the top. There are two types of banned words in Dyno Bot: Match Any Part and Exact Match. Match Any Part will consider any word that contains the bad word as banned. For example, if you ban the word hat, then chat will also be banned. These are also referred to as the wild card words. Match Exact will only ban the exact word as you wrote it. Because of this, you will want to write two lists, one for each type. Select the text box. Add your banned words, separating each word with a comma. Select the type. Update. Repeat this with a second list of words if you want. Switch to the link whitelist. Click the text box that says Add New. Add a domain that your Discord members are allowed to post links from. For example, you may want to add Twitch, YouTube, and any other social media sites. Click Save to add the domain. Head back to the modules page. Open the moderation settings. Enable any of the moderation options at the top. Typically, you will only want to enable the Delete Mod Commands option. Open the moderation log drop menu. Select the Mod Logs channel. Open the Moderator Roles drop menu. Add all your admin and moderator roles. Next, you can add protected roles. These roles can't be muted, banned, or kicked by moderators. Add any bot roles here. Dyno Bot has a lockdown feature. When enabled, all the selected channels will be locked to prevent raids or spam attacks. Expand the menu and add all of your public channels here. These are channels that everyone in your server can send messages in. If you never plan to lock down your server, then leave this blank. Switch to the Auto Punish page. Here you can set punishments to automatically occur when a moderator issues a certain number of warnings to a user. This will prevent server moderators from having to keep track of who is breaking the rules and how many times they break them. Warnings are given by typing the chosen prefix, warn, followed by the username of the offender. The default prefix is question mark. Warnings is how many times a user must be warned before the punishment occurs. The drop menu can be used to select the punishment. You can mute, kick, ban, add role, and remove role. Finally, you can select how long the punishment lasts. The only auto punishment that I like to set is 5 warnings to mute for 60 minutes. As your server gets bigger, you may want to add a punishment to ban a member after 10 warnings. Click Add to confirm. If you want to remove a punishment, then simply click the Remove button next to it at the bottom. Head back to the Modules page. Open the Action Log settings. Enable the Specify Channels for Each Event option if it isn't already. Go through all of the options and set where you want information on the events to be logged. For important events, such as bans and unbans, select your Mod Logs channel. Set the channel to General Logs for lesser important events, such as when members join or leave. Leave no channel selected for any event you don't want to see. Feel free to pause the video and copy our settings. Scroll to the bottom of the page. Here, you will see Channels and Roles. Use the drop menu to add any channels or roles that you don't want to see logs from. I'll be leaving these blank. Switch to the Modules page. Open the settings under the Twitch module. Use the drop menu at the top to select the channel the Twitch notification will be posted in. Typically, this will be a content or announcement channel. Select the text box and enter the Twitch channel name you want notifications from. Click Edit Message. Select the content box and customize the message you want to be sent when the Twitch stream goes live. Including the @everyone text will ensure that your server members receive a notification about the live broadcast. The curly bracket streamer text will include the streamer's name in the message. You can also include open curly bracket, game, close curly bracket to include the game the streamer is playing. As you edit any part of the message, you will notice the preview below changes. Click the Choose Color button. This is the color of the embed line on the side of the message. Use the bottom slider to choose a color. Click on the top palette to choose a color tone. Click Off to confirm your color. Edit the description if you like, making sure the text is between the double asterisks. I like to leave this default. Save the message when you're happy. Click Add. If at any point you want to edit or remove the notification, then you can use the buttons on the right. Head back to the modules page. Next, we will be setting up reaction roles with Dyno Bot. There are three primary types of reaction roles: verification, self-assignable, and color. Verification roles give a role that grants access to the entire server. Self-assignable roles allow a member to have multiple roles at once. Typically, the roles customize what channels the member can see in the server. Color roles will only allow a member to have one role at a time. Typically, this is for colors or other cosmetic purposes. A color role will only change the color of the member's name in your server. Now we need to set up the roles that will be used for the reactions. If you already have yours set up, then skip to the timestamp on screen. Switch to your Discord server. Click on the server title and open the server settings. Switch to the roles page. Create a new role. Give the role a name. Make sure it's relevant to the reaction roles you're setting up. Select one of the default colors, or click the eyedropper box to select a custom color. Use the bottom slider to choose a color, and the top palette to select the shade. Click Off to confirm your selection. Scroll down. Choose if you want the role to be displayed separately. For color and self roles, you'll want to leave this disabled. Also, disable the ability to mention the role. Switch to the Permissions tab. Set the permissions you want for the role. I like to clear all permissions and adjust the settings through the channels and categories. Move the role where you want it on the side. Save changes. Go back and repeat this process for each reaction role. Head back to Dyno Bot. Open the settings under the Reaction Roles heading. For this example, I'll be setting up a verification system. Select the name box and give your reaction role a title. Use the drop-down menu to choose what channel you want the reaction role to be in. Now you have three message types to choose from. We recommend using either embed or existing messages as they look more professional. For this tutorial, I'll be using the embed message. To create a message like the one in our server, you will need to use the existing message option and use the message ID. We have included links to the necessary tutorials in the description. Click Edit Embed. At the bottom, you will see a preview of your message. This is useful to see what everything does. Select Choose Color. Click and drag on the bottom slider to select the color you want to use. This is the color of the bar next to your message. Click on the top palette to choose the shade for your embed. Enter a title for the message. If you don't want one, then leave it blank. You can add a URL if you like. This will turn the title into a link. Enter your message into the description box. Be sure to explain exactly what your members need to do to receive a role. Save your embed when you're happy. Add a reaction. Click the plus icon. Search for and select the emoji you want to be used for the reaction. Expand the drop menu and choose the role you want to be given when members react. You can select multiple roles if you want. If you are setting up self-assignable or color roles, then you will need to add multiple reactions. For verification, you will only need one reaction. Expand the Options heading. Select the Type drop menu. For verification reaction roles, you will want to use the Add Only option. For self-assignable or color roles, use the Normal option. Next, you can set the allowed or ignored roles. Only users with an allowed role will be able to get a role. Any user with an ignored role will not be able to get a role. Usually, you will want to leave these both blank. If you are doing self-assignable roles, then you will want to enable the Allow Members to Get Multiple Roles option. For verification and color roles, you will want to leave this disabled. Leave the other options blank. Save. Your reaction roles will now be set up in Discord. Next, we will be setting up auto roles with Dyno Bot. With auto roles enabled, Dyno Bot will automatically give a role to all new members. First, you will need to create a role for Dyno Bot to give. If you already have one, then skip to the timestamp shown on screen. Click on the server title and open your server settings. Switch to the Roles page. Create a role. Name the role. This is just a general member role that will be given to everyone. Give the role a color. You can use one of the presets or choose a custom color with the eyedropper. Scroll down. Choose whether or not you want the members with this role to be displayed separately in the members list. Usually, this will be enabled. Switch to Permissions. Set any permissions you want. I like to clear all permissions. Drag the role where you want it on the side. You will want this role to be near the bottom. Save and close. Switch back to the Dyno Bot website. Go to the Modules page. Find the Auto Roles module and click Settings. Expand the Select Role drop menu. Choose the member role that is given to all users in your server. Set the delay. This is how long a user must wait to receive their role. Set this to 0 or 1. Ensure that Add Role is selected. Click Add. Your auto role will now be enabled. You can delete the auto role at any point by clicking the Remove button on the side. Select Commands from the side. Disable all of the role commands by clicking the Disable All button. Switch between the command pages at the top and continue to disable every command. Go to the Moderator commands. Open the settings. Select the Allowed Roles option and add your admin and moderator roles. Save. Go through all the commands and enable any commands that you want moderators to use. Each command has a brief description of what it does. I like to enable Clean, Mute, Unmute, Warn, Moderations, Mod Logs, Warnings, Case, Del Warn, and Lockdown. We don't recommend allowing moderators to kick or ban users in case their Discord account becomes compromised. However, you can enable these options if you like. For maximum server security, only enable the Clean, Mute, Unmute, Warn, Moderations, Mod Logs, Warnings, Case, Del Warn, and Lockdown commands. All of these commands can be used in Discord by typing a question mark followed by the command name without any spaces. If Dyno moves to using slash commands, then you will need to use a slash instead. To mute a user, you will need to include the time in minutes that you want the mute to last for. Locking down a server will prevent all the selected channels from being used by your members. These are the channels we added in the moderation settings. You will want to use this command if your server is raided. To end a lockdown, you will need to use the command ?lockdown_end. Switch to the Manager commands. Scroll down and enable the Purge command. The Purge command will allow a user to bulk delete recent messages in a channel. Open the Purge settings. Set the allowed roles to your admin role. If you trust your moderators, then you can also add the moderator role. Save. Dyno Bot will now be added and set up in your Discord server.